Well, good morning. We're blessed to be with you today. We do want to invite you to service on Sunday at 10 o'clock. Again, it will be good. We know that the Holy Spirit moves. You know, we have founded our church on the Word, teaching and ministering the Word of God and the move of the Spirit of God. Honestly, I can't remember a time in the service when we have not had the move of God in the service.
That's
you
right.
know, it always makes it worthwhile. I want to do something today. I want to, title would be that the Word is not a private interpretation. And there's a scripture in 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 19 through 21. And the reason that I want to share this is because I remember people, especially when I was at Rhema, Pastor Marcia, they would get revelations. I had got a new revelation.
People, and, yeah, students?
Students, yeah. And I've heard other people say that.
Yeah,
you know,
but you're not but usually the not, teachers or something
no,
like that.
But not base, but they took one scripture, okay? And off of that one scripture, they began to base this revelation. And the Word says in 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 19, "We have also a more sure word of prophecy, whereunto you do dwell, that you take heed as a light unto the shines in the dark place unto the day of dawn, and the day a star arise in your heart, knowing this first, that no prophecy of the Scripture is of any private interpretation. For the prophecy came not in old time by the will of man, but the holy men of God spake as they were moved by the Holy Ghost," and the Holy Spirit, we would say today. But I want you to understand that God brings revelation into our life, and that revelation comes from the Word of God. The difference between the Old Testament and the New Testament is we have the indwelling of the Holy Spirit,
that's
Marcia,
right. That's right.
In our lives. And as I was sharing the other night with folks, I said, no matter how many times you've read the Word of God, you cannot plumb the depth of the Word of God. It's just, and that's why every time we read it, God does begin to give us new insight and revelation.
That's right. Sometimes you'll read a scripture and you, one day you see it this way, and another day you see it.
Paradigm shift.
Paradigm
it's called
shift.
A shift.
Yeah,
paradigm.
And you see it totally different.
Yes, exactly. But what I see a lot of times is that people will build their lives on a revelation that cannot be established in the Word of God other than one scripture.
Right.
They'll pull one scripture out, you know, and the Bible says, in the mouth of two or three witnesses, let every word be established.
Amen.
And we've been teaching on Wednesday nights, is the Bible true? And one of the things I see about this in the Word of God is that God is repetitive.
Yes.
You know, he's repetitive. He will prove it or show it or demonstrate it again and again and again and again and again.
And there's organization in it. You know what I mean? It's not
structure.
Structure. That's a good word. It's not helter skelter.
Yes.
It's the same, just as he is, the same yesterday, today, and forever.
Yeah.
That's the way the Word is, right?
Yes, absolutely.
But so many people will take one little scripture and take it out of context and try to build a doctrine around it.
Yes.
And that's what happens, and a lot of danger in that.
There is danger, because people, when Brother Hagin used to say this, the challenge for all of us is to stay in the middle of the road, stay founded in the Word, and not veer off into the ditch on either side.
Right.
And we see that many times. I've seen people do that in worship.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you know, they're warring in worship. I've seen people do it. We're going to war with the devil, the camouflage suits.
And all
of that, you know, and they tend to get off into a ditch, you know, because of that. They just take one thing and they begin to build their whole lives around that.
There's even been people that have taken airplanes up above the and said they're praying over a city to break the
power of the demonic
power of the,
forces
the
around
forces.
It. Yeah.
But you know, you can't find that in the scripture.
Well, yeah, you can't find it in airplane. But see, they take Ephesians chapter 6 when it talks about principalities and powers on high, and that's what they're looking at. But here's the thing.
They can't base the doctrine on
that. We don't have to fight the devil.
No.
See, it's almost like I have to fight the devil. You know, if I'm not warring with the devil, you know, we can't have the victory. We already have the victory.
That's right.
We already have that victory.
That's it.
And it's just important for, and this is why we teach the whole Word of God, not just some of the Word of
God.
That's right. We don't get locked on one doctrine and stay right there.
That's correct.
We believe the whole Word of God. We look from, and we believe the Old Testament just like we believe the New Testament. It's important.
Correct.
You know, there are people today that are out there saying, well, you know, the Old Testament, I don't even study the Old Testament. It's not any good. It's passed away. It's no good. Well, it is good because it confirms, it solidifies what the New Testament says, and the New Testament confirms and solidifies what the Old Testament
Jesus
says.
Jesus didn't say do away with the Old Testament. He said, I have come to fulfill.
Fulfill. That's right. Yes.
He fulfilled it.
Yes.
And that's what the New Testament shows, how the prophecies given in the Old Testament came to pass in the New Testament.
Amen. I just wanted to share with that a little bit with you, that we need to make sure that if we're standing on something, that we have more than one scripture to stand on, Marcia.
Yeah.
That we have multiple scriptures, that we go through the Word of God and find that out. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We want to be correct in what we're believing in and what we're speaking. Amen. God bless you. We love you. Have a blessed week. All right.